Hi there everyone, Canadian CanAm here with another video for your viewing pleasure. Today there's four of us heading out for a cruise on late September. Today is September the 20th. A nice beautiful Saturday morning. We departed for our cruise. Like I say, there's four of us today. I'm outnumbered. There's three Suzukis, King Quads, and little old me on my CanAm Outlander. I managed to keep up with them for the most part, and nobody got hurt. No Suzukis were left behind in the woods, so that's always a good thing. So today we're hooking up with a few guys who wanted to go for a run and get the run in while the weather was nice. We said it was like plus 9 when we left this morning, and got up to around plus 16 by the time we ended the day, but it was a little bit breezy though. Kept the wind off, but they also kept the dust from flying back in your face too much. So yeah, we're going to take off. We're going for a cruise today. Check out the trails, have some fun, and go explore and see areas that we haven't been to before. So sit back, relax, enjoy the video, and enjoy the scenery as we go ATVing on a beautiful adventure with three Suzuki King Quads and a Can-Am Outlander. So as usual, our main plan for today is, to go exploring. We're not going to go get too adventurous, but we're going to stick mostly to the woods roads. But we're going to do some cut-throughs and go through a few tight spots, a few off-road trails to go visit a few ponds and stuff like that, and stop and have breaks and stuff like that. But for the most part, it'll be mostly woods road riding or wood trail riding. I said, coming up here, we're just going through one of the cut-throughs that takes you from one end of woods road to another woods road that allows you to get up to, eventually allows us to get back up to the power lines on the west side of our community. So we're just going to keep on trucking along here, go through the trails, and we're just going to explore and see what new stuff's been done to the trails, because we're going to come to one spot here in a little bit there and see that a lot of work has been put in by the local ATV club to improve the trail. And when I get closer, I'll do the old picture-in-picture thing there, and I'll show you the difference between the trail, the start of the before and after. So yeah, just sit back, relax, and no wildlife today. There was a few birds floating around in the trails, but I think got too spooked to get caught on camera, and I think we were making too much noise to catch any larger animals on the day. But for the most part, we had lots of fun. I think we did a grand total of 82 kilometers round trip. Tried to record most of it. However, I did buy a second battery for the old GoPro, but then when I tried to fit it on there, I should have pre-fitted it before I left and found out that it was loose in the case, so I couldn't use it. Well, I got most of the trip. At least I got some of the trip coming back out anyways. And when all said and done, we'll get up back up the end there. We'll see the new windmill farm that they're building in our area. So, but there's a few sights and sounds and a few conversations and just good old camaraderie riding the trails and ATVing and exploring. So coming up here on the right is what they call the Chesapeake Trail. Takes you from one road up to the power lines. It's trails used by ATVs, but last time we went through it was on the old Beaver Bank Fun Run, and as you can see in the upper left corner, it was a really, really rocky ride, very slow going, and not very easy to bottom out. The local ATV club got a nice little grant from the province and put in a lot of work, and as you can see, they've rocked in the trail a lot better, so it's a lot easier going, a lot smoother going. It'll make it easier for the snowmobile club in the winter time if they decide to groom the trails. They can get the groomer through, and it'll be a little more easier on the equipment. But as you can see by the main picture, we're already through to the top of the hill, and in the top left corner, but the old way the old trail was set up, it was we're not even to the top of the trail yet. So it makes a world of difference, and kudos go off to the local ATV club there to get that work done. That makes it a pleasurable ride now to get through the area. At least, I mean, you can actually see benefits of the work being done and allowing the sport to advance in the local area. So we're just going to cut across the trail, get up on the power lines, and then we're going to scoot up the woods roads and keep on trucking towards our adventure into the woods. So due to some technical difficulties, me mainly having finger problems pressing buttons on the GoPro, missed the whole coming into Wayland Lake. So this is where we stopped here for a break. Blowing a gale down through the lake here today. You can see the trees blowing here. You wouldn't have to worry about any flies here today. Anyways, we're at Wayland Lake here and stopped for a quick break, and then we're going to proceed back up onto the trail. But for some reason, once again, like I say, I gotta stop using the gloves when I press the button and use my fingers properly. But couldn't manage to get the video coming down into Wayland Lake. So now we're heading up out of Wayland Lake, and we're gonna get back on the woods road here and head up to our next location, which I think we end up stopping for lunch. So we're gonna keep on trucking and. Back on the main woods roads again, and like I said, I think we end up going up to Story Lake again here to stop for lunch. A couple of the boys have never been there, so we're leading the way here to get up to Story Lake. So this is where we stopped last. If you watched the last video, that me and my buddy went for a run there. He was testing his new ATV. But yeah, so that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna cruise up the trail here, get on the main woods road again, and. Head up to Story Lake and stop for lunch. Hope you enjoyed the scenery as we continue to cruise the trails in beautiful Nova Scotia. we're just gonna go up here a bit. And of course, at the end of this woods road, there's another little cut through that we have to take in order to get back onto the woods road on the other side. But for the most part, just a quick little detour through the woods. Trail's really good. The boys got her taken care of here. It's nice that it wouldn't even be a problem for side by sides or anything like that. We didn't see very many people on the go, especially in the morning. There, so you saw earlier there, we seen a fella in a pickup truck there, and it looks like he was cutting some wood. And then right around the corner, of course, there was a guy coming in the road with a Jeep. But for the most part, we didn't see very many ATVs throughout the day for a beautiful Saturday like we had. It was amazing. I think we saw two, maybe after lunch, for sure. And then we saw another two as we were on our way out. And then there's one spot there we come across a gaggle of them. They were stopped and having a break on the side of the road there. But for the most part, we didn't see for a beautiful Saturday like it was, and cool and comfortable, we didn't see very many other machines or people in the woods. So quite surprising. But it was also nice. You didn't have to worry about people kicking up dust or tearing up the road trails in front of you. Very surprising, especially now that fall's coming on and the hunting season's going to be kicking in. So soon our rides are going to be limited to when you can go, because don't like hitting out in the woods on a Saturday when they're hunting. Sundays, you're not allowed to go hunting, so we'll probably have to start taking our rides on Sunday. But we got till the end of October to get our rides in, as many rides as possible. Now with the temperatures cooling off, of course it gets darker earlier too, but try and get out before dark as much as possible. But for the most part, try and get our rides in before hunting season really kicks in gear. And hopefully get a few more kilometers on the bike before we got to kind of put a little moratorium on it there. Only go on Sundays when hopefully nobody takes a pot shot at you. So we're just going to keep cruising up here. We're almost through to the other woods road, and then we'll be stopping for lunch. Well, we're just taking our little detour now down towards Story Lake. Head down here now to the lakeside. And all that good stuff. The a few of the lads here had never been down here. Didn't even know this existed. So this trail existed. So just show them the way down through to it there. And we're going to get down here and get all geared up. And have a nice big big feed then. And have a lunch. And once we're finished lunch, we're going to get back on the trails. And keep trucking around the loop. So yeah, we kind of did the loop again this time around too. Started at a different starting point, but we still did a loop. We only have one little bit of bit we had to cross back. So here we are again, back at Story Lake, and like I say, well, time for lunch. So we've, once again, I started having finger problems with the old GoPro, and I missed a fair bit of the recording down that I wanted to record, but at least this way I managed to save enough battery to record us on the way back out the trail. So here we are, we're on the power on. We're actually on our way out now. You're going to hear some fuzz and feedback here. We had a lot of wind in the afternoon. It was probably gusting 55, 60 clicks. Of course, it got a little dustier, so it's hard to see. I led most of the way during the day, so in the afternoon here, I figured it was my turn to eat some dust, so that's why I'm in the back of the pack here. But we're just going to head up here a little further along the power lines and then cut in and follow the wood road back around to the wood road, to the turbines here on the north side of the community that they're building. We're going to stop for a break, of course. Always got to stop for a break. That's the main game plan now. Take off here, and I'm just going to follow the trail back in. But kind of holding the caboose of the trip group here right now, but after a while, after we stop here, I'll end up going in front again, and so that I won't be obscured by dust and stuff like that. You'll be able to see the trail. So I got to take my turn eating dust as well, so it's only fair that we spread it around. So we're just going to hang left here now, come off the power lines, and head into the woods roads again. Did I mention I hate puddles? I guess I kind of deserved that. I was going a little bit faster than what I should have been, but yeah, nobody likes to get wet like that. Anyways, I'm going to keep on trucking. I'm soon going to be getting up to the new road they got pushed in for the wind turbine farm. Upgrade the road significantly here so they can get transport trucks in here for the wind turbines and stuff like that. They're pouring concrete up here. Last time we were up in here, they only had the rebar down. And as you see, as we get up around in it, they've got all the concrete poured now. And these dudes in a car come in checking things out. As we go by them when they're stopped, one of them's recording me with an iPhone. But I'm also recording him, so that's the main thing. Is that he can't say I was up to anything, because I got proof here that I wasn't doing anything, just checking out stuff. Hey, just listen to the conversation amongst yourselves. We're going to go up and check out the towers.
Well, it's only going to be one of the towers, right? This is the new, this is the road where the wind farm is going. So this dead end's up here. Yeah. And you'll see there's another one just further down. There'll be another base down there. I got him on camera too. What's that? Yeah, there's four. I guess they're putting four, Tim. So there must be four in total coming up here.
I think so, yeah.
So I thought, because this is right there, just on through the trees is the power lines. Be up and running by February.
Well, this pretty well concludes the ride for us for today. My video is going to stop here shortly because the battery finally died in the GoPro. Didn't get a chance to quite get the rest of the trail. We ended up going down through the 5K trail and then joining back up to the trails to get back to our vehicles. Not bad day. We started at 9 o'clock in the morning. I think we pulled into the vehicles around 5:30, so almost 8 hours going today, which worked really good. I got most of it on camera, except for a few spots where I had finger trouble. So yeah, we're just gonna head back out and all the good stuff. I want to thank everybody for watching. Thank my three amigos here, Suzuki amigos, for coming along for a ride today. So we had a lovely day, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Stay tuned. I'm sure there'll be more to come as fall comes in and we enjoy the cooler temperatures for ATV. As for now, stay safe on the trails.